in the face of immortality, morality is going to radically change, right? We've evolved to die. Like, if for the entire history of life on this planet, life has come to an end. There is nothing in our consciousness, there's nothing, period, out there that says, this is how you behave if you live forever. This is how you start to structure a society if I can store my personality on a computer. This is what I do if I can store that personality onto a computer and download it into another body. These are huge, far-flung, really strange questions, right? And they seem totally science fiction at this point, but everything we've seen over the past 25 years, right, is most of the science fiction canon from the 20th century has turned into science fact in the 21st century already. So this 21st century sci-fi idea of mind uploading, it's probably going to be here by the 22nd century. So we've got 50 years, 70 years to start figuring out these really complicated, hard questions. The idea in mind uploading is that we can store ourselves on silicon. We can upload our personalities, our brains, some part of our consciousness onto computers, and they can stay around forever. It is a far out there technology, for sure. Even though British Telecom was working on it, even though people are working on it, it's very early days. Ray Kurzweil has famously kind of pegged the date when we're gonna have to deal with this problem is 2045. That may be really, really enthusiastic. I think it's a conservative prediction. But the point is, at some point in this century, this is probably gonna get real. And you gotta stop and you gotta go for, you know, all five of the world's major religions, just start there. Use the threat of the hereafter, right? What's going to happen after this life to steer morality and shape behavior. So what happens to theological morality in the face of technological immortality is the big kind of metaphysical question. If you look at the science fiction work of Richard K. Morgan, who's fantastic, he talks about what happens when consciousness becomes downloadable and bodies become expendable and what that means for soldiers and armies and mercenaries and things along those lines. So there's really like a gritty cyberpunk underbelly to the mind uploading technology, even though it's being developed for educational purposes. So we could preserve the brains of the Einsteins and the Beethovens and the Richard Feynmans of the world and really kind of get inside them. But it's sort of like, I think of it like television, right? When they created television, they thought it was going to be used for educational purposes. That was the only, that's the creator of TV. What do you think this will be good for? Well, education, of course. 50 years later, there's not much education. There's a whole lot of crap. And I think we could see the same thing with mind uploading. But the difference, of course, is that mind uploading, storing selves on silicon, even teetering on the edge of so-called immortality, changes everything about what it means to be human at a really fundamental, deep level. When I say fundamental, deep level, I mean we're starting to muck around and mess around with evolutionary processes we have no idea what happens if you interrupt them because we've never done it before.